try to speed through this as quickly as possible just to provide some context for the things I describe in the subsequent video. Long story short, when you start out as a young aspiring filmmaker of any sort, you're probably messing around if you have access to a camera, filming, sort of innocent things with people you love. Not really expecting them to be good, but just, working your muscles, your nascent filmmaker muscles. From there, you, whoops, can't quite zoom out like I'd like. Okay, you probably move on to another step from either an overpriced film school or you're a bit of a street hustler, finagler, networker, both of which, sort of go in tandem. There's no one way to skin a cat, obviously. Perhaps you even worked in commercials or attempted music videos after 2009. Perhaps you tried to get through diversity or grant programs. Good luck to you. But usually, while in pursuit of those things, you will have attempted a short film or web series and maybe a full-length feature film if you are so blessed, which is sort of what I discuss in the following video. From there, often one of these creations will lead to either or, you're attempting to get into a big festival or attempting to put your work on YouTube, maybe both, right? And depending on how that works out, you may have another opportunity or not. I feel like this is fairly self-explanatory. There's sort of a few routes that can result from whatever you've made. Maybe you'll have to go back, rinse and repeat, or you'll, and have to make another film or web series, things of that nature. But depending on what you've made, you'll be on one of two tracks, right? Maybe you've gotten representation or not. But usually this sort of leads to two different career outcomes, right? Which ultimately lead to your actually being employed or a bit less of a sort of fortunate result, right? Which we've seen many a time. The end goal of this is, obviously there's nothing wrong with going back to make more short films or web series or even feature films if you are so blessed. But the ultimate goal is to get to the point of actually working so that we can then go and have a family, have children, have love, own a dog farm, and again, appease our parents as they approach their twilight years. This is sort of the life cycle that I have witnessed over probably 18 years of studying the industry. I'm sure people could add other elements to this paradigm, but I feel like it's fairly comprehensive. But I just wanted to offer this up to provide some context for the things that I will discuss in the subsequent extraordinarily long clip. So thank you for sitting through that. Just gonna figure out how to get out of this and